the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
I am conscious that in the USA today is Thanksgiving Day. Now, there are many things American that I have my doubts about, but one of the American things which I wish we could adopt in this country would be an annual day of Thanksgiving. And therefore I've decided to offer this Mass as a Mass of Thanksgiving. Sing and make music to the Lord in your hearts, always thanking God the Father for all things, in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. As we gather before the Lord, who blesses us in so many ways, let us open our hearts that we may be blessed with his mercy. Lord Jesus, you came to reconcile us to the Father and to one another. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You heal the wounds of our sin and division. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You intercede for us with the Father. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, who always listen mercifully to your servants in distress, we humbly beseech you, as we give thanks for your kindness, that, free from all evil, we may constantly serve you in gladness, through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, for ever and ever.
Amen.
Bless the God of all things, the doer of great deeds everywhere, who has exalted our days from the womb and acted towards us in his mercy. May he grant us cheerful hearts and bring peace in our time, in Israel for ages on ages. May his mercy be faithfully with us. May he redeem us in our time. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
I thank you, Lord, for your faithfulness and love. I thank you, Lord, with all my heart. You have heard the words of my mouth. Before the angels I will bless you. I will adore before your holy temple. I thank you, Lord, for your faithfulness and love.
frustrates me that tomorrow the UK seems to have adopted willy-nilly the American custom of Black Friday, but it hasn't gone before that to have this Thursday of Thanksgiving. Thanksgiving is really important. I read yesterday a comment from an American Benedictine monk. Gratitude isn't simply an emotion that happens to arise at times. It is an act of the will, an intentional resolve to have a good attitude, an effort to notice easily overlooked blessings. Now, it may be my own curmudgeonly self, but I can think of slights and difficulties, and we all know that these times we are living through have their own troubles. And yet, even now, there are blessings. Even now, we can make that act of the will to appreciate the good things that are around us. The Holy Eucharist is, by very definition, the great thanksgiving. The great thanksgiving for the mercy and grace of the Lord given to us in Jesus and made accessible to us through the sacraments. Jesus is here. His love is here for us. We have received many blessings. We have much to be thankful.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you. Fruit of the earth and work of human hands, it will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you. Fruit of the vine work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands, for the praise and glory of his name, for our good, and the good of all his holy church.
O Lord, who gave us your Son to rescue us graciously from death and from every evil, accept, we pray in mercy, this sacrifice, which we offer you in thanksgiving, for deliverance from distress, through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For although you have no need of our praise, yet our thanksgiving is itself your gift. Since our praises add nothing to your greatness, but profit us for salvation through Christ our Lord. And so, in company with the choirs of angels, we praise you. Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the Jesus, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory." The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope and Vincent our Bishop and all the clergy. Remember, Lord, also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs of eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him, away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. I invite any participating online to make an act of spiritual communion. How can I repay the Lord for all his goodness to me? The chalice of salvation I will raise, and I will call on the name of the Lord. Let's go.